Great here. Welcome back to Factorio, where we're so close to robotics. I know I've been harping on it for the past couple of videos, but this is where I really like Factorio. In fact, in some of the modded campaigns that I've run, I start off with construction robots and a personal roboport, just so that I can have I can make constructing things a bit easier. And in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a bunch of repair packs, and I'm going to dump these into the network. That way, if anything gets damaged, these construction bots will pick up the repair packs. Let's see. I'm trying to show you. Let's see. How do I shoot? Controls, let's see. Shoot. This is how little combat that I do. Me in combat, meh. Okay, connect, trains, focus, item, next weapon, queer drop, it should be next to space. Okay, shoot enemy space. Shoot selected is C. So, if I shoot this, notice that the construction bot comes out and says, "Hey, stupid! Stop doing that!" Sweet. So basically, this entire area in green is now protected by these construction bots. If anything gets damaged, they'll run out and repair it, which is a good deal. Okay, so we still need to make some of these things by hand. We're getting our logistics network up and running, which is all fine and dandy. I'm so happy that I got this far. And the funny part, remember how I said that I started this campaign once before and I messed it up? Well, I got to 14 episodes recorded before I realized my mistake, about 7 hours, and I had only just gotten to the oil stage in that 14th episode, so I'm doing a lot better this time around. While we're waiting for everything to take care of, yeah, let's get these barrels and run them down to the oil area. This is actually going to be the first logistics run that I'm going to use, I think. I don't know. I'm still doing decent with carrying everything by hand. As long as I remember to do it. Actually, the first logistics that I'm going to set up is actually getting blue signs taken care of. So let's get these in there. Speaking of blue signs, more advanced circuits. We need more filter inserters. There we go. I could automate the production of this, but I don't. I want to do that with the robot network, because now the robot network starts shuffling things around, and then I can, with the construction bots, I can start tearing the jankiness down and redoing everything. Notice how they finally completed this section over here. So that is going to be very nice, just being able to get all of that taken care of. Okay, so there's another 30. There we go. We're getting there. In the meantime, what I can do, I need batteries and steel plates to make the frames. Oh, standing here, I can grab all. No, I don't want the green circuits. Please stop with the green circuits. In fact, you can have all my green circuits. There we go. So I'm still making plastic. Let's get a bunch of batteries. There we go. Let's steel plate batteries and electric circuits. Yeah, let's start making frames here. Yes. You pull out to there. No. Where's my steel chest? Let's limit this back to 50. You pull out to here. And you make flying robot frames. Okay. So, flying robot frames needs batteries. Electric is coming in. Green circuits, which I have over here. Those are engines. I don't want the engines to go any further than that. But what I can do... Janky. Let's get a filter inserter. There we go. And you, I want you to pick off green circuits. There we go. So now the green circuits will be fed in here, so I don't have to run another line up. So I just need steel and batteries. And my battery production is there, and steel is there. So, what I can do... is, again, run this backwards. I need more transport belt. It'll be so nice when I can actually get logistics robots up and running. Yeah, I still have more there. Okay. So for the time being, let's work on this. To there. Nope. Like so. Perfect. So let's get a splitter here. And... we need a underground here. There we go. So we can just put a splitter here. Hello, splitter. There we go. Like so. That will get me my battery and steel. And that should be frames, I hope. Will everything load up with just these inserters? Yes, they will. So, let's have a frame output there. Into a chest. Which we're going to limit to 50. Just like everything else. There. Okay. We're out of filter inserters, so let's get many more of those. And I need fast inserters, which require iron plate. Oh, I'm out of iron plate. Okay, got it. Okay, let's keep making these until I start making circuits. There we go. How close am I? I'm 2/3 of the way there. Meanwhile, I've got frames being made automatically. So, let's actually make this first one a... logistics robot. There we go. And let's throw this puppy in the air. Ta-da! There he is. He's so majestic. He can't actually do much because I do not have any logistic spots in my inventory, nor do I have the logistics network up and running. But we're getting there. In the meantime, can I actually make lasers? Yeah, steel plate, electric circuits, and batteries. Steel plate, electric circuits, and batteries. Well, I've got everything right here. Huh. I wonder how I could do this. Because I actually have a plan for this frame construction right here, so I don't want to crowd that in too much. How far can I reach this? I can go to there and have that go up, and then have this go under and have this come up here, and on this other side is where I'll put this. I need a long-handed inserter, and you need lasers. So, batteries, steel. What is the exact? 20 electric circuits, 12 batteries, 8 steel. Oof. Okay, well, on second thought, I'm not going to have, there we go, I'm not going to have a long-handed inserter in there. I have two, no. Two fast inserters. And we need power. I need to make more power. I need to automate power, because I'm making this by hand way too much. And then we will have, let's have a passive provider chest. There. And in fact, I'm going to take this off of the bar. I'm no longer going to make steel chests. I'm going to make passive provider chests from here on out. Whoops. This needs to be limited to 50. There we go. So let's get what I need to make a passive provider chest. I need steel chest. Oh, I picked up plastic, not steel. Because my steel ends right here. Okay. So let's just make two for now. Lock those in place. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And now I've got lasers. I get freaking laser beams! These have, if I put this there, and then I pick up, where are my guns? You notice how the range, there we go, the range on the lasers is much further than the guns. The guns, they don't need power to operate, the lasers do. So this is a good spot for my first laser, because I have no defenses on this side, and I have the base, this giant base over here. So, yeah. But at least now we are working. We have gun automation up and running, which is excellent. What's slowing down? We need more of these, which I'm not going to do like that. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. I need green circuits galore. There we go. Okay, I need to stop those because I need inserters. And we're just going to make as many as we can. Get these up and running again. We're so close. Okay. And what I'm going to do in the meantime, can I make another blueprint? Yes, I can. There we go. Okay, let's get this blueprint in this in the book. And what I want to do... Oh, it's... I don't have anything in there. Darn it. Well, can I make another roboport? No, because I need steel plate. There, I got steel plate. Can I make another roboport? Yes, I can. Okay, I need to extend my robo network out as far as possible. I basically want to get all the way over to there. So, the first one needs to go somewhere in here. Right there would be ideal. I don't need this anymore. Yeah, this would be perfect. Let's get this. Come on. There we go. And we need power off to the other side. Okay, so now I've got my robo network out to here. Can I build another one? Yes, I can. No. I don't have the advanced circuits. Why are these flying over here? What are you... Oh, it's down here. Remember when I had the biter attack down here and they nibbled on things down here? These are coming down to replace all of this stuff down here. Which is kind of nice. And I really should replace that... Well, no. I'm not replacing that furnace on purpose. In fact, get rid of it. There we go. Well, that was very nice of them. Okay, so... Red circuits. Right. Steel. What are these? What are you guys missing? You are missing... batteries. There you go. Tons of batteries. We can just grab all of these advanced circuits, please and thank you. Okay, one more roboport. I think I'll have enough. This is where the base really starts to shape up. I mean, think about it. Just about, I don't know, I'm about 7 hours in to this campaign right now. I'm pretty sure there's a way that I could look that up. I don't know how. And remember, I started out right here with, you know, one little burner miner over here, two burner miners up there, and I have this, you know, gigantic empire of stuff. And I'm still building. Oh, right. I came out here for the roboport. Okay, where's the ideal? The ideal spot is going to be... right there. I can make that work. Okay, so where's my roboport? See, I have to make sure that it connects. And I want the orange areas to line up. This is basically the max distance, which normally you're not too concerned about. And... there's our fast. Now we need to cram power in here somehow. There we go. Perfect. Okay. This, expected resources, 0. So I've now tapped out that miner. I still have some expected resources out of this one. Expected resources out of this one, nothing. So that one is completely tapped out. So now, I believe, yes. What I can do is replace this with a passive provider chest. Can I make another passive provider chest? I want to make another passive provider chest. Or, yeah. Okay, one more. So let's put that here. And okay. And let's limit this one to 200 as well. Okay, so now I have 200 walls over here. I have a ton of brick in here. You know what? Yeah, this is fine. Okay. So, now what I can do is I can say move to this, a brand new blueprint. And I could say, hey, I want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 section of wall. Okay? Now I take this new blueprint. I say, I want 10 section of wall. Now, let's deconstruct these. And now that I have the network extended all the way over to there, what I can now do is I can tell my logistics robots, or my construction robots, build me a wall. And there, this will eventually be built by these construction robots. Which means I no longer need this wall section in my inventory. At least not now. So I'm just going to dump all of those into the storage chest. What the storage chest does, it just acts as a place where they can keep stuff. So whenever I deconstruct something, it goes to a storage chest. Why are you not running? Really? Why? Has that been not running this entire time? Okay, so now I have my network all the way over here. Now what I need to do is I need to extend it down towards the oil area, and I can automatically bring oil up, but I finally have logistics up and running. So let's get character logistics slots 1, which I should have done a long time ago. So now what I can do is I can say, okay, grab... No, this needs to be a requester chest, which is this. So let's build one requester chest. And I can now put that there. Now with this requester chest, I shift right-click on this to paste the... what am I thinking of? To paste the recipe. And I can paste the recipe into the requester chest. And now the requester chest is going to say, hey, give me 2 batteries, 2 advanced circuits, 2 filter inserters, 2 steel plates. But I want each of these to be actually more than that. I want them to be 20 each. Okay. Now, I should have a logistic robot flying around here somewhere. I thought I did. Actually, let's force the issue, because I have a bunch of steel plate in there. So let's bring the steel plate into my inventory. And over here, here's the logistics robot. Puttering along. What he's going to do, he knows that there is steel plate in this passive provider chest. He's going to pick up a steel plate from here, like so, and he's going to come up here and drop it off into this chest. And that's what he'll do. He'll just keep going back and forth and making sure that this chest has whatever it needs to operate. And then when he's done, like I said, yes, I know these are super slow right now, but they get better. He powers up, goes back into the nearest RoboPort, and sleeps. So now, I don't have to move everything around by belt. I don't, with construction robots, I don't have to build everything by hand. Now, I can do a lot more automation than I wasn't able to do before. Well, a lot more automatically. So, oh, that's going to be so much better. So now what I want to do is... Actually, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to put a cut here, and we'll pick up tomorrow. Now that we've actually got logistics robots, we've got construction robots, we can start really ramping up this factory. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.